now, not tomorrow. How many times have you told yourself, I am going to do this particular task tomorrow, and then when tomorrow comes, postponing it, and the cycle goes round and round and round. Do it now, not tomorrow.
Dear lady, I want you to discover your strength. I want you to believe that you will overcome challenges. Imagine your reality. Inspire selflessly. Dream fearlessly. And go chase
you. Guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lizzette. I create videos to inspire you and to motivate you to live a positive and flourishing lifestyle. So welcome to episode 2 of Girl Chase Your Dream. Is that one thing you have always wanted to do, but you keep on postponing it, like, oh, I'm going to do this tomorrow. I'm going to do it tomorrow. And when tomorrow comes, you still postpone it to the next day. There is always going to be that tiny little voice in your head telling you, oh, just leave it. You have a lot of time. You could do it tomorrow. Oh, by the way, I think this thing is too hard for you. You cannot do it alone. Just wait for your friend to come and assist you. In fact, you can't do this, just forget about it. It's always going to be that tiny voice that is going to try to discourage you not to do something, not to take immediate action, to keep on procrastinating, to do your activities. You have to kill that tiny voice and don't give it an opportunity to take the stage in your life. We all have our goals, we all have our plans, but in as much as you have those goals and you have those plans, you have to keep yourself motivated. And you have to take actions towards achieving those goals. And there are two things that can delay you or can slow the process of you achieving your goals. That is lack of motivation and the spirit of procrastination. Because no matter how brilliant you are, if you don't take actions towards your goals, they're never going to turn into reality. So in this episode, I'm going to be addressing certain steps or practical steps that you could take in order for you to stop procrastinating, or in order for you to feel motivated to take baby steps towards achieving that dream goal of yours. You should always remind yourself of the outcome of doing that task. I'm going to say that focus on the long-term happiness. Most of us, we always focus on the short-term happiness, like what is this even going to do to me that I'm even stressing myself to do it now? No, don't focus on the short-term goal. The thing that you can do to keep yourself motivated or to prevent yourself from procrastinating is that when you find yourself in a situation where you feel less motivated, you don't really feel like doing something, it happens. There are times that I'll get up in my bed or before sleeping, I'm saying to myself that, oh, tomorrow I'm going to have a productive day. I'm going to film 3 videos. I'm going to film 4 videos. I'm going to edit. I'm going to do this. Excuse me, I'm using myself as an example so that you guys understand it much better. And it's like what I'm going through. So yeah, as I was saying, find yourself in a situation like that. You have to constantly remind yourself the reason why you started, why you are doing that task. Why is it important for you to do that particular task? Why is it important for me to complete this task before this date? You have to remind yourself of the why. When you remind yourself of the why, I bet you it's going to ginger you to work harder. For example, there are some days that I just get up and I don't feel like filming, but I know that I'm supposed to film. I know that I am supposed to put out content on a weekly basis. But some days I'm like, I really don't feel as to film. Then I'm just going to sit and ask myself that, what if is this video that I'm supposed to film that is going to make me to blow? Man, come and see the way I will just fly from my bed and just start arranging myself to film. So you always have to constantly remind yourself why you started something. When you feel less motivated or when you don't feel like doing a particular task, just ask yourself that, why is it important for me to do this task? And when you have the answer to that why, I bet you it's going to ginger you. It's going to help you to feel motivated to do that particular thing. Let me take this student example. An assignment and it is due in 2 weeks' time. And you're telling yourself, oh, I'm not going to do this assignment now because I still have a lot of time to do that assignment. But I bet you time flies. Before you notice it, it's going to be 2 weeks and the deadline has caught up with you. You should ask yourself that, but why is it important for me to do this assignment now than to keep it for next week? It is important because when you do your assignment before the deadline, gives room for you to do other activities because you know that you have already done this one. Another thing why it's important for you to do your assignment before that deadline, the fact that when you do that assignment now, maybe before that deadline, have a new idea and you go into your assignment book and make one or two adjustments. Doing things at the present, not postponing, it always gives you time or it gives you room for adjustment. Another thing which you can do to stay motivated is to have a buddy. For example, when I was taking the GC examination, I had a buddy, I had a study buddy. I had my friend Sharon, we were like 5 and 6, and we held ourselves accountable. We were always studying together. We ask ourselves questions. When she has past questions, she'll forward them to me. We'll meet up and we'll discuss. If you could have a YouTube buddy, you can have that sister or that brother on UIT Street that if you have a difficulty, you can always meet up. Or you guys can talk about your plans at the beginning of the week. Oh, I'm going to achieve this. Okay, Sunday we are going to talk about what we have done throughout the week. If we have a productive week, and when you have a study buddy, it just powers you to take action because you don't want to be left behind. You don't want a situation where your friend is only telling you, oh, I've done this. But you also want to be in a position where you tell your friend, oh, you know what? I had 5 things to do this week and I did them until I even added something else that I did not plan to do this week. So I'm going to advise you to have a buddy. As for me, I have YouTube buddies. Buddies. Having a buddy should be somebody that has shared his or her own goal plans, or somebody who has his or her own goal plans also, so that you guys work together in achieving that goal plan. It should not be somebody that is just there, it's only you who has plans and no one talking about your plans to the person. No, it's not going to really work that way. The reason why it's good to have a study buddy is the fact that you hold each other accountable. It could be as a result of your thoughts playing a game on you. Your thoughts can be doing dodgeball, like they toast you this way and they toast you this way. So you need to reframe your thoughts. You need to reframe the way you are thinking. Once you change your way of thinking, your actions turn to follow as well, because if you're thinking that something is difficult, for you to take action achieving that is going to be difficult. But once you have it in your mind that, oh, this thing is easy, you just see yourself doing it like A, B, and C. So here go, your brain can be telling you that, oh, so you really think that you can pass this biology exam. Others have failed this exam. You really think that you can pass this exam. I want you to tell your thought that instead of you thinking that you are not brilliant enough to pass that exam, tell yourself that, oh, this exam is hard, but I know if I work hard, if I work extremely hard, I'm going to score better. I'm going to have good grades in this particular exam. Tell yourself that, oh, this task is challenging, but it is doable if and only if I focus and put in extra work. It is very achievable. You know, lack of confidence also can fuel your thoughts, because if you don't have confidence in yourself, you just feel like everything that you want to do, it's not doable, or it's difficult for you to do. By the way, I have a video on how to boost your confidence. I'm just going to leave it up here. You don't always think that a particular task is challenging for you to do. And sometimes we actually feel less motivated, or we actually procrastinate because we are tired. So sometimes it is good for you to just take a break from everything you're doing. Take a break to renew your mind, renew your strength, and you know, rethink about everything. Then when you come back, you'll feel more focused and more motivated to do things. And also, at times we just need to change our environment, because your environment plays a lot in your productivity. It might just be that your space is too crowded for you, so it doesn't give you an opportunity for you to think. With all that said, it is very important for you to keep away distraction, because we have a lot of things that distract us nowadays from achieving our goals, from taking actions, which I'm going to be elaborating more in episode 3. So let me know in the comment section, what are some of the things that you do to keep yourself motivated? What are the things that helps to fuel your energy when you don't feel like doing certain things? I see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.